My dearest mother, I hope this letter finds you well. I've learned so much since coming to New York. I've met many wonderful people, and they've helped me figure out who I am and the reasons why I must fight.
And that is the girl wars show So Long My Love. So I don't know if I'm going to go straight into Sakura, into the new Sakura Wars game when that comes out, partially because I don't know if that, if the release is going to be delayed or whatever due to logistical nonsense. But either way, thank you very much for watching this with me.
You once told me that hope can never betray us, and that we never live alone. I didn't understand it then, but now I think I know what you meant.
That was fun. If you enjoyed the stream, or if you enjoyed watching this Let's Play, please consider backing my Patreon at patreon.com/count0or. I'll have this the edited version at the end of the thing. Patreon backers get access to my episodes up to a week in advance for the edited versions. And you get to pick what future games I do next. Final thoughts on Sakura Wars. So Long My Love. This is like the first visual, like this is the first visual novel I've like properly beaten or played all the way through. I've played the second, but for the US, the first Utuwari Romono game, Utuwari Romono Mask of Deception. And I actually like this game a lot more than Mask of Deception in from a gameplay standpoint, because you have those walking around portion. You get to go out and do something and experience the world more. Whereas Utuwari Romono is very linear. There's not a lot of branching options there. So I like the tactical gameplay of Utuwari Romono a little more.
Maybe I can't say I'm a worthy man. But at least I'm satisfied
with
my life.
I like the music of this game
a
bit more. I wish I have the collector's edition, but I wish it had a soundtrack. I really wish it had a separate soundtrack. Where this game stumbles is like properly recognizing and realizing a steampunk 1920s New York. That's where things kind of fall on their face. Like, we get this with a depiction of Harlem in the game's second chapter. We get that some with Rosita, the character of Rosita. How Subaru's character is handled falls into the category of good for but okay for the time, but that ain't saying much. And it's one of the things where it's like, it's kind of cringy. It gives the game a lot of cringy moments that makes it awkward to come back to now in 2020, almost two decades after the game first came out. I am incredibly glad I played it, though. I do like to actually do something interesting with the closing credits, as opposed to we're just scrolling, text. It actually does something with this. Like, this is something that a lot of straight up freaking, like, other American video games, not just JRPGs, like American video games in general, can do something with this. Give you something to look at the closing credits than just the scrolling text, and keep you engaged and watching to watch the way through, and give the programmers and staff the credit they deserve. Anywho, other than that,
they told me I could come back to Japan anytime. But I think I'll stay here a while longer. I'm not ready to leave my friends just yet. In love, Shinjiro.
All right. And then we wrap up with the, yep. I appreciate. Okay. Alright, I appreciate that your new game, like your game clear data, is not taking up a save slot. That is nice to see. So.
Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the show, please like and subscribe. Also consider backing my Patreon. Patreon backers get episodes up to 1 week early of this show and any future Let's Plays. Also, please consider backing my Ko-fi. Toss me a few bucks also helps support the show, and it's not a monthly obligation or anything like that.